This morning, a report released today finds that there are still too many children in the U.S. welfare system not living in families. But here in the district, there is some encouraging news. And joining us now is Hai-Suk Chung, the executive director of DC Action for Children. She's got more now on this report that was just released this morning. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.
And let's get started with the good news and what it is that's, that the district seems to be doing well.
Yes, sure. The district, we have a rapid response program, and what it does is really within hours try to place children in welfare system with families or next of kin, which is a huge, huge challenge in the welfare system.
And so is this something that has recently been implemented, or is this a tactic that the district has been working on for quite some time?
It has been a strategy over the last few years, but as we know with child welfare, it is extremely difficult to intervene with families in abuse cases, and often when we interact with families, it is in a very negative situation. So to have a preventative program like this, it takes a lot of time and effort, and luckily our child welfare system, our agency with their leadership, really prioritize this as a strategy and an intervention. So it's great news for DC. It is a system that's working.
And so that is why DC is kind of coming out ahead
yes.
of other areas, is because they're able to get these children in with families much more quickly than other areas?
Exactly. And, you know, nationwide, we're still lagging behind the national average, but for the numbers in the district, we are improving. And when we say improving is that they are placed with families. They are placed in situations that were they're likely to be reunified with their families or get into a permanent foster care situation.
That is great news. And, you know, we were just talking about, you know, the Relisha Rudd story
exactly.
made, you know, such unfortunate headlines for so long here in our area. And you were saying, you know, that is that tends to be the case, that welfare doesn't, child welfare doesn't tend to come into the news unless it is a bad story.
Exactly. And when we intervene, it is often an emergency in a place in a very, very tragic situation like the Relisha Rudd story. And we, what we want to do is get real-time data around the situation of the child and the family so that we can intervene much more quickly, but also prevent situations like the Relisha Rudd case. And unfortunately, there is no one to blame and everyone to blame. It was a very tragic story for the district, and unfortunately, it's not over.
Right.
But what we can see here from this report is that when we have strategies that work to really focus on the well-being of that child and the long-term impact of that child, then we have the right strategies in place.
Well, and obviously what we're doing here in the district is working a little bit.
Yes.
Every step forward is it's progress. So
that's right.
That is good news. Thank you very much for coming in and talking with us
yes.
today about this report that was just released this morning.
Yes.
Some good encouraging news. All right. Hai-Suk Chung, thank you very much.
Thank you.